Hello boss babes and bosses out there. So in this video, I'm going to share with you what a general virtual assistant actually does. Like, ano yung clinic-click nila all day? Well, I share with you kung ano yung mga tasks na ginagawa talaga ng isang general virtual assistant. Let me share what I'm doing here in front of me right now. So ito po yung monthly task namin dito sa bahay ni Ate Olive. Kung matapos kasi namin to within a month, free yung rent namin. So dito nakasalala ang budget. Joke lang. Hindi po free kahit po matapos to ng one day. Parang ano lang, it's a group thing na kung gusto mag-unwind, mag-chika-chika dito sa may sala, like may ginagawa, something like that. So, meron akong ambag dito before. I did the outline. After that, wala na talaga akong na-touch dito. So, ang dami pa. Naka-sort na siya. Sila yung gumawa nito, actually. Yung mga ka-housemates ko. They are so good talaga when it comes to mga puzzles. While I share with you that, let me also do some unbug here in our puzzle. Are you ready? Let's dive in. So I'm just gonna share with you my experience as a general virtual assistant way back home ha. Like, ito talaga yung 9 common tasks talaga na ginagawa before. Ang first talaga dyan is yung file management. Diba, meron tayong mga documents ba? Minimake sure natin na may folder. So for example, meron tayong files when it comes to mga bayarin natin sa SSS. So meron tayong folder na nakalagay talaga SSS payment contributions. Tapos lahat ng mga receipt pag pay natin, dyan natin ilalagay. Yung ganun ba? Like, may label, tapos nakasort by date, by time. Anyway, hindi necessary ang time sa pagbayad ng receipt or whatsoever. But you get what I mean, right? The same din yan sa mga soft copy. So yung mga soft copies, ito yung nasa computer natin. Kasi yung physical documents, tinatawag natin na hard copies sa computer. Meron tayong nakasave na PDF, videos, photos, spreadsheet, Excel, Word, yung mga ganun na mga documents. Dapat naka-name din sila ng tama para mas madali natin siyang makita. So, dapat nakalagay din siya sa folder na tama din. And we should also name the folder correctly as much as we can. Kasi, napansin niyo ba, ako din, guilty ako dito. Like, meron akong ginawang assessment. Ilang revisions ko na, like, nilalagyan ko siya ng assessment 1, final. Tapos may nire-revise na naman ako. Assessment 1, final. Tapos may revise na naman. Assessment 1, final. Parang gano'n, di ba? So, saan ba natin yan siya sinesave? There are 3 cloud storage na I would highly recommend because ito yung mga ginagamit ko. Even before and even now, Google Drive, Dropbox, OneDrive. Most of my files talaga, my personal files, most of mga clients ko, they also prefer Google Drive. Maybe it's because the friendliness of the user interface. Meron siyang free storage capacity ba na for free. You can upgrade naman if you want. If marami ka nang hinahandle ng mga clients, it's very easy to access everything kasi like you just really have to type sa search bar and then magpa-pop up na doon yung mga files na hinahanap mo. Try to use it. Try to upload files, share files sa friend mo kung wala ka pang client. By the way, with that being said, meron pala akong tutorial sa paggamit ng Google Drive. You can check out this one here and let me know if you want to do a tutorial on how to do OneDrive or Dropbox. Just comment it below. Technically, they just really works the same lang talaga sila, but different UI lang. The same functionality and the same concept. Merong mga features on Google na wala si Dropbox and OneDrive. Tama ba ako? Anyways, basta, what I can say is that si Google Drive, easier siya gamitin compared sa Dropbox and OneDrive. But you can try to explore that one kasi merong mga clients na gumagamit. For me, I just go sa kung ano yung ginagamit ni client. I just really want them na easy lang yung pag-work nila sa akin. The second one na masasabi ko is email management and customer management. Ito talaga mostly na pinapagawa. Kasi usually, yung mga business owners, mga entrepreneurs, they are too busy to respond na sa mga emails sa customers nila, sa mga collaborators, sa mga business partners. Parang inaasa na lang nila sa mga virtual assistant yung mga ganong task. Which is, handbida naman talaga ng mga VAs, no? I already have a video tutorial again for that, so you can watch this video here. Usually, ang mga emails ni client, based sa mga clients ko, ang na-try ko na ma-manage ni email is yung Gmail, Outlook, as well as iCloud Mail. And meron pang isa, yung client ko ngayon, Telstra Mail. For example, you are currently using Yahoo Mail, then you can try that. Basically, it's just just the same. Pero iba-iba yung platform. You know what I mean? So for the third task is yung calendar management and appointment setting. Especially if yung client nyo is very jump-packed yung schedule niya. Marami siyang meetings, marami siyang need i-attend ng mga deadlines and all. So you should also know how to create mga tasks, mga events sa calendar, and as well as, you know, creating appointment calls or meeting. Very repetitive but still so impactful para sa client nyo, guys. Technically, mayroong calendar management na pwede nyo gamitin for this tool. Pwede din na Zoom kung gusto nilang mag-meeting virtually, as well as Calendly, mag-booking ng consultations. Meron ding tinatawag na equity scheduling. I haven't tried it, but I heard a good feedback na maganda din daw siya gamitin. By the way, I already have a tutorial for calendar management sa Google, so you can check out this video here. It's just very easy na task. What I would say lang is that you have to make sure na yung calendar mo for that particular client is nakaset talaga sa time zone niya. Kasi yan yung nagiging challenge ko before. Especially yung isang client ko na doctor siya and may podcast siya. Tapos yung mga ini-interview niya sa podcast niya is from a different time zone din. So, make sure na yung time zone na nilalagay niya sa calendar is tugma sa time zone ng ka-meeting niya at ng client mo. I think that's the challenging part when it comes to you setting up the calendar of your client. So, for the next task, so yung financial workload management. What do I mean by that? So, na-track ng isang VA yung mga finances ni clients. Mostly, yung mga receipts, mga invoices, mga expenses, and even mga money ins. Kung nag-hire si client ng bookkeeper na mag-file ng tax niya, then it would be easier na for the bookkeeper kung nakalagay yung mga expenses ni client sa right category. Ang ginagamit dito usually is yung Google Sheet or Microsoft Excel, QuickBooks as well, and then Xero. Na-try ko sa Google Sheet and as well as sa Xero. I'm not sure kasi yung sa akin nakaset up na yung kung ano yung tax na ilalagay or ilalapat sa expenses na yan. Nakalagay na dun yung GST on expense, on income, yung mga ganun. So, you have to know kung saan siya nakategory, kung anong kind of expense siya, yung mga ganun. Usually, tinuturo naman yan ni client, especially kung wala ka talagang alam, and sabihin mo lang na wala ka pang idea niyan kasi they are willing naman to teach kung ano yung dapat mo talaga gawin. You can try those mga software, especially for Google Sheet kasi free lang naman. For QuickBooks and Xero, I think there's 30-day trial na pwede mong gamitin para mag-explore lang sa tool na yan. So, if you want to focus more on bookkeeping, we have 2 videos already. In-interview ko dyan si Abby and nag-share siya dyan kung ano talaga yung task ng isang bookkeeper, saan makakakuha ng work, ano yung mga rate na pwede mong ibigay kay client and all. So, you might want to check out these 2 videos here. If you want to contact Abby, you can also follow her Facebook page. Ito yung Facebook page niya. Another thing din na napansin ko once you are a general virtual assistant, a lot of my clients before, especially there are entrepreneurs, mga small business owners, they also want me to manage their social media and community like Facebook groups. Isa to sa task talaga ng isang general virtual assistant. At least, alam mong mag-handle ng social media. Technically, mga basic-basic lang naman talaga yung gagawin nyo. If you want to know what are the tasks ng isang social media manager, then I have a full playlist for that. You can also check out this playlist here if you want to deep dive more on sa social media management din na task as a virtual assistant. Usually, yung mga platforms na ginagamit namin dito is yung Meta Business and marami ding mga scheduling tools like Hootsuite, Buffer, meron ding scheduling tools si Canva and SocialChamp. You name it, ang dami talagang pwedeng gamitin na nakakapagbigay din ng social media report para kay client. You can check out the playlist para mas malaman niya talaga yung in-depth kung ano yung gagawin dyan. So, another task pa na ginagawa ko before is itong project management or online business management. Typically dito, ako yung nag-oversee sa lahat ng programs ni client or business ni client. For example, ha, ito yung ginagawa ko sa isang client ko before kasi nagpa-podcast din siya. At the same time, meron din siyang consultation and gumagawa din siya na content online for YouTube, mga video content. Minamanage ko dito yung video editor at saka graphic design designer niya kasi magkaiba. Iba yung nag-i-edit din ng podcast, iba din yung nag-write ng vlog. Ino-oversee ko lahat yun na dapat smooth siya, kukuha yung deadline when mag-post, when to mapublish, when a meeting, when mag-schedule ng interview sa podcast, yung mga ganun. With that being said, mas need natin ng project management tool in order for us to know the deadlines for each project. For example, ang favorite ko talaga is yung Asana. Very easy to use lang. I also have a video on how to use that one. You can check out this one here. It's a step-by-step tutorial on how to use Asana. If ever naman yung client niya is not that so techy, I would highly recommend Trello. Trello is the same like Asana, pero mas madali siyang gamitan. A lot of my clients na hindi medyo tech savvy, mas nakakaintindi sila kung paano gamitan sa Trello. You can also use that. Marami pang mga project management tools like ClickUp, Monday.com. So you can try all of those kind of mga project management tools. And it's up to you kung ano yung mas feel mong gamitan for your clients or even for your personal projects as well. Okay, so for the next task is yung research. Super helpful talaga ng research task, especially for those mga clients na nag-handle ng business online. Kasi most sa task na pinapagawa nila sa akin before, it's more about competitive research, market research, and paano i-position yung branding nila. So for example, na yung client ko before is nasa clothing, ano siya, merch. Pinapacheck niya sa akin kung magkano, if ganito yung mga designs, and even yung mga colors, kung ano yung mostly patok na colors, the type of hoodie, the type of products na mas mabili. Very helpful talaga kasi mas magiging effective yung marketing mo and yung strategy mo overall sa business mo. It would be much easier for you to target the right market. So with that being said, ang mga tools na pwede mong gamitin, first talaga sa ranking natin is yung Google search. Like very, very helpful yung Google search when it comes to mga general data. Lahat ng need mo i-ask, you can just ask Google about that. Hindi mo talaga makakaila na top 1 talaga yung Google search. Mas marami kang makikitang mga details, mga data na need mong ibigay kay client. The next one I would say is yung BossedUp. If you are doing a content for your client, then I guess BossedUp can really help you with that. For mga keywords naman, you can also use keyword research and SEMrush. So napaka-helpful nila na magbigay sa'yo ng mga keywords na mas ginagamit sa market. So it's very important to use the right keywords para mas madaling makita yung products mo or yung blogs mo or yung mga articles mo sa website. Another task din na may isi-share ko sa inyo is yung data entry. A lot of clients sa akin before na nag-a-ask na magpapa-input talaga ng mga data lang. Like literally copy and pasting data. And you have to be very keen to details talaga dito. Especially when it comes to numbers ha. Kasi even just one number lang, like it would affect a lot of data na sa client mo. So usually ang ginagamit ko dito before is yung Microsoft Excel or let's say Google Sheets, Word documents, and Airtable. So there are a lot of softwares pa naman and tools na magde-data entry ka lang. Especially for let's say WordPress, like literally copy and pasting details sa WordPress, sa Shopify na lang, yung mga ganon. You can also try that. Ang skill mo lang dito talaga is to have an eye and attention for details. Okay, so this is the last but not the least, I would say. Kasi marami pa, hindi lang to sila, pero ito yung mga pinaka-common. So the last one that I would share na is yung basic creative support. When I say creative, yeah, you have to be creative. Kasi it deals with graphics or deals with video editing, some kind of that. For example, yung client mo is more on into entrepreneurship or a coach siya, yung mga ganun. Literally, they would also ask you to do a basic marketing type of thing and content creation. So, dito, you would need to have an eye for graphics then. Sometimes, papagawin ka ng isang flyer, business card, kahit branding niya sa website niya, branding niya sa social media niya, ikaw yung gagawa. Even just, you know, the basic, like kung ano yung type font na gagamitin, magbabagay ba yung combination of colors and all, yung mga ganun. Mashishare ko na tool tool na pwede mong gamitin is first, when it comes to graphics, yung Canva talaga. Canva is a very good tool for mga graphic designers na beginners pa. And if you are a little bit more intermediate now when it comes to design, I would highly recommend Adobe Photoshop or Adobe InDesign or Adobe Illustrator. Something na mas powerful pa kesa sa Canva. So you can also try that one. But you know why Canva can really do most of the graphic designing na kailangan ng isang client? When it comes naman to video editing, especially for mga short vertical videos na, I would highly recommend CapCut. CapCut is so easy to use then. Maganda din siya for beginner. So if you are still starting pa talaga and most of mga shinier ko sa'yo is wala ka talagang idea, don't get overwhelmed. Kasi everything is figure outable talaga. If you are just willing to learn new things and nag-i-enjoy ka sa ginagawa mo, then I would say you would be a good virtual assistant in the future. Kasi ganyan din ako before. Like, I also don't know sa mga ginagawa ko. But I'm willing to learn new things. I'm willing to explore new tools. Yung mga discomfort, mga unfamiliar tools, those are mga tools na pwede mo naman talagang matutunan. Actually, hindi naman lahat. At least, isa lang doon sa mga sinabi ko. Like, for example, isa sa mga cloud storage. At least, isa sa mga social media scheduler. You just have to learn at least one. Hi, say hi. This is one of my... ka-housemate dito. And say hi, Dre! Say hi, Dre! Nagluluto si Dre. So if you are willing to learn mga new skills, virtual assistants na service, then I have a full list, like 40 videos for free. Step-by-step tutorials talaga siya. So you can check out this playlist here. And yeah, if you like this kind of video, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the like button. Follow us on my Facebook page at BossedUp PH. Follow me on my Instagram accounts at BossedUp PH and at Bricksui. And also, I've been so active nasa LinkedIn, so you can also check out my LinkedIn page, BossedUp PH, and my LinkedIn profile, Britsy Suzy Sudatar. So yeah, hope to see you on my next one. Bye!